I'm going to tell you the best apps for YouTube videos and all of the apps that you need as a content creator.
And we're starting right now.
What is going on? My name is Nick from tubertools.com. Welcome to another video. If this is your first time here and you want to learn how to grow your channel, make videos and all types of other YouTube related stuff, start now by subscribing and clicking the bell so you don't miss anything. Okay, so on this list, we've got free versions and we've got paid versions, and it doesn't matter what device you're on, if you're on an Android or iOS, we've got you covered. And for this video, I have a very special guest with me that has an entire channel dedicated to helping mobile YouTubers. My brother from the same mother, D.
If you're making content with your mobile phone, the first thing you're gonna need is a video editing app. These are some of the ones that I found to be the best. For Android users, check out KineMaster or PowerDirector. Both of these are professional grade video editing apps and give you full control over your edit. If that's what you need, check these out. If you need a totally free video editing app, check out the app called Vlogit. It's not as full featured as the other apps, but it does get the job done, and well, free is free.
Now, if you're on iOS, you can use KineMaster like D talked about a second ago, or you can level up a ton and use something called LumaFusion. LumaFusion is a full-featured editor. It's just like pro editing software on a computer. The only difference is instead of it being on a computer, it's on your phone or your tablet. Now, downside of LumaFusion, it costs money, but if you don't want to spend any money, of course, if you're on an iOS device, you can always use iMovie.
The next thing you'll need are apps to make your YouTube thumbnails and your YouTube channel banner. The best part about all of these apps we're gonna talk about now, they're free, as in nothing, zero, nothing.
How much?
Free.
The first one is Snapseed. Snapseed, like D said, is absolutely free, which is awesome, but it allows you to fully control what an image looks like. So if you wanna pump up the contrast, you wanna give it more saturation, anything like that, you just wanna make it look awesome, use Snapseed. The next one is Pixel Lab, which is also free, but the difference between the two is Pixel Lab will actually let you stack layers on top of each other, which Snapseed just doesn't let you do. Snapseed is cross-platform, so you can use that regardless of the device that you have, but Pixel Lab is Android specific. Now, if you're on an iPhone, you'll wanna use PixArt. And with PixArt, when it opens up, you might think like, hey, wait a minute, I think this is paid. But in reality, all you have to do is close the ad and then you're good to go. If you want detailed instructions on how to make your thumbnails or how to make your channel art on your phone or even editing videos or any of that stuff that has to do with your phone, check out D's channel. I'll put a link to his channel right here.
Now, if you wanna make better looking videos, you're gonna need manual controls on the camera that comes inside of your phone. However, if you don't have manual controls, check out one of the following apps. The two that I recommend are Moment Pro Camera and Filmic Pro. Moment Pro Camera is available for Android and iOS users. It's a full-featured camera app, and it's also the least expensive of the two apps. You're not gonna go wrong with this app. Filmic Pro is also available for Android and iOS users. It's another full-featured camera app, and it's gonna help you make better videos.
Both of these apps are full-featured apps, and they allow you to do pro stuff, like change the frame rate, for example. So if you're a vlogger or something like that, and you wanna make that like buttery smooth B-roll that you see in a lot of vlogs, then these apps will help you do it. Now, of course, if you are a YouTuber, which I'm guessing you are, you probably wouldn't be watching this video.
You need to download the YT Studio app. This app is made by YouTube, and it's available for both Android and iOS users. This is where you go to check your analytics. You can answer your comments here. This is how you find out what's working on your channel and what's not working on your channel. If you don't listen to any of the other app recommendations in this video, download this one and learn how to use it.
You can also use YT Studio to update your titles, change your thumbnails, or anything like that that you need to do to your videos. So at least get that in your phone right now. Next on the list is something to help you solve the problem of finding other people to make videos with, like D and I have been doing today. Collab Space is the app that will help you do that. It'll help you find other people that are around you to make videos with. Next on the list is the TubeBuddy app. You probably didn't even know that TubeBuddy had an app, did you?
Well, they do, and there's a link to TubeBuddy down in the description below. TubeBuddy is available for both Android and iOS users, and it's gonna help you keep track of things like your live subscriber count and your video view count. It also has great features like canned responses and
a video topic planner, and they have something really cool called milestones. So let's say that you cross a certain amount of subscribers or a certain amount of views, you can download a certificate from them, totally free, and use it as bragging rights to share on social media. Now, once you have all these apps installed, it's important that you learn how to use them. And if you're a mobile content creator, it's important that you learn how to do all of this stuff the best possible way on your phone. D's channel is gonna help you do exactly that, and he's gonna teach you how to use all of the apps on this list, in addition to teaching you just how to master your mobile device as a content creator. So here's what I want you to do. Click on this, head over to D's channel and subscribe to D so that you can learn more about creating on your mobile device.
Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.